Have you ever asked yourself some questions at midnight, like, why is life like this? Why is my life like this now? These questions can surely lead to a night full of existential crises and no sleep. Because as most of us know, these questions seem dangerous to be left with. However, if you tackle these questions by searching a quick search on Google, you'll find the answers are quite simple. Your life and life in general are like this because of how the universe progressed since 14 billion years ago. And eventually because of how life operated and evolved, according to the conditions around it for almost 4 billion years on our planet, Earth. Physics led to chemistry, organic chemistry led to biology, which led to the rise of complex animals and their ethology, and in our case, psychology, which led to sociology, history, the rise of our civilization, etc. Satisfying as the answer might sound, it still didn't satisfy you. The answer spawned more fundamental questions like, but why? Why is life special? And why did it appear in the first place? Why does it operate this way? And why did it evolve this way? Can there be any other way that life can do this stuff? Well, if this was you someday, and you're not a biologist, then you have the mind of one. Because life is a matter of biology. And biologists have raised these questions many times at different times with no legit answers. Till the field that we will discuss today finally appeared. Xenobiology. The architecture of life. Xenobiology is about exploring other possibilities of life and is mainly concerned with manipulating and synthesizing biological systems to push life to its limits, knowing its secrets. Before we dive into manipulating and replacing the architecture of life, we need to understand the basic architecture of life first. The genetic code of all life on Earth right now is coded and preserved by a molecule known as DNA, which is a nucleic acid composed of sugar phosphate backbone with nitrogenous bases sticking out of it. These bases, adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine, are the basic programming language of life. And when it's arranged correctly, they produce genes, which are transcribed to the messenger RNA, another nucleic acid similar to DNA but has a different sugar in its backbone and uses uracil as a base instead of DNA's thymine. The RNA then enters structures called ribosomes to be translated into proteins, where every three bases on the RNA strand is called a codon, is translated into one amino acid, where there are 20 amino acids used in all living organisms. The sequence of the codon determines which amino acids will be added to the protein chain. Hence, the sequence of the messenger RNA transcribed from the gene determines the amino acid sequence of the protein, which ultimately determines the structure and function of the protein. Proteins are literally what give rise to the complexity of life, carrying out structural, biochemical, and transport processes necessary for life. This is the basic architecture of life, but xenobiologists argue that it does not define life. The insight of xenobiologists. Xenobiologists see that our insight of life is so limited to what we see on Earth, as from their perspective, life is not limited to the environmental conditions that we see on our planet. They take that multiple steps further and conclude that it is not even limited to the architecture of life that we explained earlier, or even the chemistry of life. For anyone hearing this right now, it will seem that xenobiologists stripped life from all its unique characteristics, and will be hard for anyone hearing this right now to even imagine what are they even talking about. Allow us to illustrate their point of view. The first point that they're talking about is clear to most biologists. Life, with all its diversity on Earth, is limited to its ecological pressures. What is even more mind-blowing that some characteristics of the contemporary organisms, especially complex animals, are suggested to not have a beneficial function to these animals, but had a function to their ancestors, as the four limbs of a tetrapod. The altered architecture of life. The second point is the most significant one of the three, and the main focus of xenobiologists. The DNA-RNA protein sequence of expression of traits in living organisms is old-fashioned to xenobiologists. They want to alter it either by adding nucleotide pairs that carry novel bases to our nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, or engineering biological systems that use an expanded codon dictionary, so they can use more amino acids and produce xenoproteins that will ultimately give rise to alien traits. As usual, this is not enough for our mad scientists of the field. they want to push life even further by engineering novel nucleic acids. Here, we arrive to the mascots of our field. XNA is any engineered xenonucleic acid which is completely unknown to any biological system we know. By many here, we mean that there are many types of XNAs, such as GNA that has a glycerol backbone, and TNA that has a threose sugar backbone, and many more. The significance of xenobiology. You may conclude after this very short introduction to the field that it surely satisfies your curiosity, answering some deep questions that is very interesting to philosophers of science and science fiction authors. But you may ask if it's worth the huge amounts of money spent on its research, because at first, it does not seem as the field has useful practical applications. That is far from true though, as it has many futuristic applications that we will soon need for advanced biological experiments. Let us give you an example. By XNAs, we can build what is known as the genetic firewall. This simply causes the inability of biological systems with different architectures to exchange genetic material. This is of great significance because it will allow us to give rise to our own biology. Our own organisms, populations, communities, and even our own ecosystems that will not be able to exchange any genetic material with us. Hence, will not have any direct dangerous biological interactions with us. We will be able to use this novel microbiosphere and its components as models to everything. We need to study on how life works. And since we are the ones who engineered them, we will be able to alter them arbitrarily, and maybe even bioethics will be applied on them. But we will leave this to be discussed by the philosophers of science. Thank you for watching. We hope that you enjoyed the video. If you have another field of study that you want us to discuss in a future video, feel free to leave it down in the comment section below. We tried our best to give you a brief about the goals, exotic ideas, and promises of the field, without explaining the complex science behind it. But if you're interested, as always, there will be further readings in the description down below, for the ones who want to dive deeper in the field. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends and family if you learned something new.